Hi BookTube, it's Gina, and I'm here today to talk to you about Strangers from the Sky, my very first Star Trek book. This, I read on my Kindle, and this book, I wish I had a paper copy that I could have and show you and save forever, because this book is gonna always have some really, really special memories and associations for me. The first one being that I read this while I was on vacation with my sisters. I've talked about this a million times already, but I just got back from a vacation. I have not traveled in 2 years, like everybody. And I was reading this book on vacation at the pool on my Kindle, which was wonderful. And I'll insert a picture somewhere up here. It was such a wonderful vacation, relaxing pool time, spending time with my sisters, and just feeling like a normal person again after being quarantined for so long. I recognize that it's probably a little bit foolish to be traveling for pleasure still at this time. I'm a little bit conflicted about that, but it was wonderful. And so this book is always going to remind me of that sister trip. So that's the first thing. The second thing is I'm reading this book as part of Book Trek 2021 with some wonderful co-hosts. And this is always gonna also be a really fun memory for me. My first time reading Star Trek, my first time co-hosting a readathon like this with some friends that I've met on BookTube. Steve Donahue, Mark Richardson, who are just, you know, the big guys on BookTube, and Vin at Revenant Reads, and Michael K. Vaughn, who are newer BookTubers who started their channels right around the same time that I did. I'm gonna put this down now. And who I've just really enjoyed getting to know a little bit and reading books with them and watching their videos and having them watch my videos and comment. It's just been so much fun and such a wonderful experience. And this is just the beginning of Book Trek. So we have 5 months of fun to continue to have. And so it's just so much fun. I'm gonna keep saying that. Getting to know these guys and being able to participate in this readathon with them is such a treat. And it's just something I never would have expected in my life, that I would be doing videos and reading with these people that I've met on the internet. And it's just wonderful. So this book is always gonna be that memory for me too. So it'll always have really special connotations. And in addition to that, I loved this book. It was so much fun. I have a feeling that all of the Star Trek books may not be of such good quality, because I've heard that they're not very good. And this one was fantastic. It is by Margaret Wander Bonanno, who, again, I don't really know anything about. This is my very first Star Trek book, so I don't know much about it. I was sort of frantically trying to look stuff up as I was reading it to make sure I didn't miss any connections or, you know, backstory. And I gave up on doing that about midway through just because I wanted to just relax and enjoy the story. So I'm sure that there are some connections and things that I missed. But basically, this story is a story within a story. It is the original series, so it is Spock and Kirk, and them, of course, trying to save the world, which I just, of course, loved. And they sort of go back in time, and then there's a novel or a story. I guess it's supposed to actually be a true story of how Vulcans first landed on Earth. And then it also ties in, I wrote the name of this down, Where No Man Has Gone Before, which was the original series episode with Gary Mitchell and Lee Kelso, where Gary Mitchell becomes godlike, and his eyes turn silver, and he ends up getting killed by Kirk in the end. So I rewatched that episode. I read the book, and it was so much fun. The book was very well constructed for a book where the timeline bounces around and the characters bounce around. It was so well written, so well paced and plotted. I loved it. I also really loved that it explored the characters in a little bit more of a deep way that they just don't do on an hour TV show. So the relationship between Spock and Kirk was really interesting, because it was partially in the beginning of their relationship where Kirk was trying to figure out how to deal with this person that was so different from him. And I just loved seeing their relationship start to build and to grow and develop. That was fantastic. And I also thought it was very almost relevant to our current day, as far as people being afraid of the unknown, being afraid of aliens, and just tying all of that into, she tied it into the IRA movement and terrorism in Ireland. But I think it's fear of the unknown, terrorism, all still so relevant to society today, unfortunately, right? That's kind of a bummer that all these years later we're still dealing with the same issues. But I just thought she did a really good job. It was deeper than I had thought it was going to be. So I think this was a really good one to start with, because it was just really an interesting and well-written story. I loved the relationship between Gary Mitchell and Kirk, and it made me a little sadder that Gary Mitchell ends up dying in the TV show. And I love Lee Kelso's character, who also died in the TV show. Oh, sorry, guys, that was spoilers. I guess I should have said that. But anyway, and it was funny that Lee Kelso ended up being a computer hacker. And they were just all such comedians. There was some really funny parts to it. So I just really enjoyed this book. And I'm so glad I read this for my first one, because I think it was a really great way to kick off my book trek 2021. I've got my other piles back here. I'm going to keep reading, but I really wanted to talk about this book because, like I said, I think this is going to have such fun memories for me as being my first Star Trek book, and just a really fun time. So thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you later. Bye.